I'm going to show you how you can use Power BI Desktop and connect to data coming from a SharePoint folder or a specific SharePoint file or contents of a SharePoint list. Let's get started. So here I have my SharePoint file and I have some folder structure in there, and in there I have some files that I would like Power BI to connect to so that I can set up a one-click refresh or automatic refresh. So that's the first thing that I have. So let's start there connecting to a SharePoint folder. So I'm going to switch over to my Power BI desktop window. Here I am, and I'm going to click Get Data and click More. And again, that was, I had clicked Get Data, and in that, the More dialog box, and that should bring this dialog box up. And here, what I would like you to do is just type in Share or SharePoint, if you like, and you would see the SharePoint folder option right there. And I want you to hit Connect. And now it's gonna ask for a site URL. For that, I'm going to go to my SharePoint site again, and I'm going to copy the whole URL here and just come back and paste it in here. Although, if you do that, you're going to notice this warning, and it's going to say that, the URL isn't valid, and it's saying, please enter the site's root URL only. Actually, if I had paid attention, even this information icon is talking about this root URL. So what is that talking about? So what it's talking about is that, it doesn't need this whole URL. It really needs just the root URL, which points to your site, and it'll probably look something like this. So keep your site name in there, but yeah, trim everything else out, and at this point, you're gonna hit OK. While that's coming up, I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. All right, our dialog box came up, and this is where a lot of people get lost, because this dialog box comes up, it's like, oh, gosh, what is it showing? It's showing me some kind of files, and the button that it seems to want you to click is Combine, but that is absolutely the wrong button to click. You do not want to click this button. Bad things will happen. you'll see. So you don't want to click that button. Instead, the button you want to click is the golden transform data. In fact, that's the one that should have been color golden. So let's go ahead and click transform data. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna launch the query editor. And by the way, if you're just starting out or you seem to keep getting stuck in Power BI, then I'll also link to my Power BI tutorial in this video. All right, so here we have, and what it's gonna show you, it's gonna show you all the files in that SharePoint site. Now, I'm pretty sure that you would not wanna pick up all the files from there. So what you want to do is zero in on this folder path option and specifically select the folder, only the folder under which you want to get the file. So what I'm going to do is in here, and this is a demo scenario, so I don't have that many folders, but either you can select the folders or you can use text filters. Let me just show that to you really quick. So what you can do is go in here and text filters, and you have lots of different options. You can say the folder path needs to contain a specific keyword or begins with this or something like that, right? So, of course, you can do an exact match as well, equals this. For now, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select this products folder and hit okay. And even after that, it's possible that within that folder, you might have a whole bunch of files. And in this case, maybe I only want to get the Excel files and I do not want to get the CSV files. So you have all of that available to you. In fact, if you really wanted to, you can even do the similar kind of filtering on the file name. And you can say, hey, only give me the files which begin with products underscore or something like that, or containing, something. So for now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to filter by extension, keeping the Excel file, and hit OK. All right, so now that we have exactly the files in the folder that we wanted and only the list of files, now finally we're ready to combine and get the data. And you do that using what I call the action button over here. So again, if you zero in on this, notice if you hover over this action button, it says to combine files, and that's what you want to do. So I'm just going to click it, and it's going to take a little bit, and I'm going to be right back. All right, so Power BI came back with this. Now, usually if the files are well structured and they all are of the similar structure, I'm assuming they are if you're trying to combine them together, then you can pretty much accept the defaults here. You know, you can tell it which sheet you wanna bring that in and just hit OK, and it'll pull in and combine all those files. All right, Power BI is back, and when it's combining Excel files, it does create this substructure, which I wouldn't go into now, but it has already done the right thing for you. And here you can see we have all the Excel files in our folder, and I can see the contents of the files have all been combined. I'm just going to give it a good name. Let's call it SharePoint Folder Files. All right, so that is our step one. Now let's move on to step two, which is how do you connect to a specific file on SharePoint? So in this case, we're not, maybe in some scenario, we don't care about the folder or all the files in the folder. Maybe we just want to focus on just one specific file. So for that, the way I like to do the trick is to open this file in your desktop app. Once the file opens up in your desktop app, you can go to the File tab and Info option and click on Copy Path. Again, you want to go to File, Info, and click on this Copy Path button. Once you do that, and I'm going to just stick that into a notepad over here, and this gives you the path of the file. Now, if you're, you know, if you really wanted to, you could probably read by hand as well, but I just copy path it like that. But there's one key change you must make if you want any hope of this to work, which is this last bit, this question mark web equals to one, that needs to go. So you want to delete that, and that path is good enough. Now we're gonna go back to our Power BI file, which is here. Actually, I'm just gonna stay in the query editor. And in here, I'm gonna say new source. And this is where sometimes I get wrong. I'm pretty sure if you try Excel, it doesn't work. And I think the better option, or the one that I use, is I say web. So get this from web. So I'm gonna click that and paste that URL that I just got that by copy path and editing it. And that should be able to, oh, perfect. So that got the Excel file, and it's going to show you all the sheets. In this case, I just have one sheet, and I hit OK. And that is the way to connect to a specific SharePoint file. We're on to our last one, which is to connect to a SharePoint list. So here I have our students list, and we got Batman, Cyclops, Flash, and we have the awesomeness index. Oh my gosh, some of these rankings should be higher. But anyway, so this is our list. So let's go back to Power BI Desktop. And we're still in the query editor. We're going to stay here till we're done the queries. And in this case, I'm going to click more again, get new source more. And I'm going to type in SharePoint again to get to the option for SharePoint list. Now, my understanding is the SharePoint list is for an on-prem list. This is the one that we're using, SharePoint online list. This is on a SharePoint online site. So you hit OK, and it's going to feel similar to the folder. So now you see the site URL. And again, it's similar to that. By the way, there was one step that was not shown earlier because I'm already signed in. The first time you do this, it would ask you for credentials. All right, so again, the URL is similar to how we specified it before. It is just the site URL. I often copy paste the whole thing, but it doesn't really need all of that. It only works if you give it the root URL. So we have that set, and I'm going to hit OK, and there we go. That's what I was waiting for. So this sometimes can be confusing. You don't want anonymous for sure. You don't want Windows. You typically want what is shown as Microsoft account. Sometimes I've also seen this being shown as an organizational account, but either way, that's the one you want. And I'm just going to sign in. All right, so I'm signed in and I'm ready to go. It has my credentials. I'm going to hit connect. And again, it had my site URL, but now what it's going to do is going to look through the site and show me all the lists that are available. Now, it does show you some of the system lists that are available as well. Now, I had no idea I had all of these lists on there. The only one that I had created was this Learn Power BI class list. But let's look into that. And And again, once you click on this, the first time I did this, I'm like, whoa, this is not my list, because it does show you a lot of system columns as well. But I'm glad, the content stands out. So awesomeness index. So this definitely is the list that I'm looking for. But again, the first time you do it, it might look really confusing. You can see it has lots and lots of different columns. But for the most part, you can ignore those. So I'm just going to select that, hit OK. And once that loads, what I'm going to do is I'm only going to keep those two columns that I care about. So I only care about this title and this awesomeness index. And I'm just going to right click and say remove other columns. So there you go, my friends. So we have connected to a SharePoint folder. And you've seen all the gotchas, all the tricks to connect to a SharePoint file and to a SharePoint list. Now I'm gonna hit close and apply, and hey, make sure to click on the screen to watch my next video and also check out my Power BI tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe, click on the circle thingy on the screen, and I'll see you next time. Until then, power on. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.